Thank you, Rangika. Right. We're going to industry, so Engineer Jaro. Industry, the infrastructure and innovation all comes in SDG 9, but we address this in a way of what we have done and what we are
doing. Yeah. Very good evening. All of the participants and the listening guests and the engineers, ladies and gentlemen. First of all, I would like to thank IESL, IPESL to celebrate World Engineers Day with the focused concept in sustainability. Sustainability is not a new for apparel industry. I am here to present you or sharing our experience, how we started the sustainability with our operation toward achieving the sustainable goal. Our journey started in 2008 with our green factories at Blendix and MAS Holding. So then our sustainability was a part of our operation. That is our competitive advantage in the region. So, and also this apparel and the textile industry was a highly polluting industry before 20 years ago, two decades ago. So that's why that our achieving this goal is a very vital area. In this area, engineers' contribution is very much important. They are working on this one. And you can see this is a $1 trillion business in the world. The apparel sector in Sri Lanka, we are contributing around 0.7% of the apparel market. So still we have a potential to grow in this area, and we have a workforce, and we can achieve this one. And here, if you take in employee workforce, 70 million people are working in the apparel sector. In Sri Lanka, only 0.3 million people working. So there are, you can see that still apparel industry contributing the global carbon emission around 10%. If you take this sustainability goal, so we align that three area. Main area is air, is basically is the energy, and water and earth. Earth is a material and the waste management. So under the energy pillar, so you can see that renewable energy, energy optimization, we make together, and we are using our infrastructure more sustainable. And under the water pillar, how you use the natural resources and utilize for our process and our occupant consumption, and also how you are protecting your water sources without polluting your process space water. And also the earth, how we are using the high, larger quantity of the resources for our manufacturing, because our materials, our product, our apparel needed the material and also chemicals and water and energy. So if you go for this, our sustainable development goal, under that one, there are targets. These are the selected targets. We are working on that one. Under this one, so we have, there are four strategies we use. One is the resource optimization, how we can optimize our resource we are using, and how to adapt our renewable energy into our process. And finally, the how we are practicing the sustainable best practices among us, and using our sustainable infrastructure when you are planning your construction or new infrastructure. This is our framework. So under this energy pillar or air pillar, we are focusing mainly the optimizing our energy consumption, because a lot of potential or room for improvement in that area, so that we are optimizing our energy consumption, then our minimizing our need for renewable energies to become a net zero by 2023. we take apparel industry in Sri Lanka, there are leading place, Mays Bendix, Hydramani. So those places, they committed to become a net zero and or carbon neutral by 2023. So we are very well ahead before sustainable development goal achievement by 2030. For achieving this net zero, so our contribution in the national energy consumption is the 5%. In that 5%, if you see that our renewable composition, so they are 3% of our contribution, you know, that rooftop usage. Because we have identified as a rooftop solar, because we can get you the benefit due to the cooling effect in the roof. And also we can minimize the losses from transmission. So there is still our contribution is around 27% by installing around 30 megawatt solar in last year. And there are more than 25 megawatts in pipeline. And also we have converted our oil fire boilers to biomass boiler with the support of ensuring our sustainable biomass supply through Sustainable Energy Authority and then UNDP. So you can see that mixture of our energy, so we renewable energy mix, we hope we can achieve by 2023. So energy optimization, there are a lot of engineering aspects, especially the HVAC system and the water management pumping system. So we try to make optimize and using by latest technologies, and especially the converting our fluorescent lamp to LED lights. At Bendix, we have more than 33,000 fluorescent lamp we replaced in last 2 years. It's saved more than 1.2 gigawatts of energy in our sector. So, and also our all green building, we try to use solar tubes or skylighting or double glass glassing for view as well as the lighting. And we use the VFT, VST pumps and the air handling units. And also we use the task light just to achieving our requirement in the 1,000 lakhs at the needle point. These are our main area focusing the green building. So because this is a good opportunity give us to ensure our design, our engineers' contribution to design in the architecture level to commissioning the building, consider adapting the sustainable or green features to that one. So that's why that our green building supporting us to minimize our energy consumption as well as the water consumption. So if you take in Sri Lanka, there are 17 LEED certified apparel building in Sri Lanka. Among them, there are 6 platinum rated buildings in Sri Lanka and around 1.5 million LEED certified area. We are very proud in the world. Bendix, one of the facilities in Bettiklo, become a world second highest LEED platinum rated in the manufacturing building. And also, so you can see that our contribution in the green building. If you go for the water conservation, so there are a lot of potential we had. And basically, we have a dyeing process. We use a lot of energy water for dyeing process. So therefore, our investments on the advanced machineries with the low liquor ratios and high efficient and water efficient machineries. And also, there are a lot of potential where they are recovering their condensed water. And also, we have done a lot of investment on that water and sanitary fitting, because more than 27 employees at Bendix itself working, because they are home at the daytime in our facilities. Therefore, we have to ensure their water consumption sustainably or conserve with by meeting their requirement. So our focus was the ensuring our facilities to become a zero liquid discharge in our Bettiklo plant and the Rambukkana plant. We already made as a zero liquid discharge, and we are working to minimize our consumption by per capita to achieve 35 liters per head by 2023. So this is one of the projects we have done in the 2 years back to ensure our all our employees getting that safe drinking water, and we are able to eliminate like using this PET bottle and the in-house treatment facility to remove our PET bottles in the operation. There are some initiatives we have done. So due to the limitation in the time, so I will wind up here. So specifically, I want to mention here is material circularity. So Brandix and the MAs, you can see their product is they are able to make it that material, so that using the PET bottle, like he said, they can make it. Even Brandix also, we are working on that one. So together to ensure bringing the technology in Sri Lanka to get the our material, fabric material, to reuse it and reproduce the garments in our nation. And also we are working on to the paperless and the digitalization. So almost our information, all documentations are now is digitalized. Thank you very much listening this hour. We are hoping by 2023 our contribution will be ensured to meeting our sustainable goal, and our engineers' contribution is very much involved and appreciating our engineers in all in the sector. Thank you very much.